how satellites stay in the orbit. It's a wonderful thing to know, right? So if you see how a satellite is put into orbit. This is the Earth. So if you travel, if you walk on the Earth for 8 kilometers, Earth is a round shaped ball kind of thing, right? For every 8,000 meters or 8 kilometers, Earth bends by 5 meters. That means from this point to that point, basically it drops down by 5 meters. The point is a bit lower than this, right? So a satellite, when it attains, let's say 500 kilometers altitude above the Earth and traveling at a speed of, let's say 27,000 or 37,000 kilometers per hour, the speed is adjusted such a way that for every second it travels a distance of 8 kilometers or 8,000 meters. That means when you put a satellite around here, once the spacecraft attains this height, altitude at that speed, the satellite is made to travel at a speed of around 8 kilometers per second or 8,000 meters per second. So it travels in 8,000 meters and it drops 5 meters. And again it travels 8,000 meters, it drops 5 meters. So satellite is a balance between forward velocity and the gravity of the planet. The exact balance. So satellite is an ever falling object. So once you put the satellite into orbit, it would not require any energy anymore. Right? It would not require any energy. It will always fall down towards the Earth using none for thousands of years. You understand? So basically that velocity is matched to the curvature of the Earth, curvature of the planet. Right? If Jupiter has, let's say, some other curvature, Jupiter is the biggest planet, then the speed will be different. Right? The speed and the altitude will be different. When you calculate, so then you can make it into your orbit. That is why in Chandrayaan 2, once they put into parking orbit, once they launched on 22nd July,